Pleasure to meet you both. I followed your work very closely. I'm Detective Total, but I'm on the side.
So what did you find?
Well, the usual. Mom takes kid to the park. Kid plays some hide-and-seek with his mom. Kid hides in the bushes, and kid finds... I guess you just have to see that.
Did you get an ID on the victim?
Waiting for you to arrive.
What about the cause of death?
Whatever it is, it's, well, we've never seen it before. You'll see that for yourself.
Is that the family over there that found the body?
It sure is. We're getting a statement now.
Well, make sure you get a thorough statement from him and don't let him go until I talk to him.
Yes, sir.
Sounds like a routine murder investigation. Why'd you call us in?
You'll understand when you see the body.
Close crime scene.
Here. It's not close to us. This is Special Agent Caleb and I'm Special Agent Alice. Mind if we take a look?
You're my guest.
God! Who could have caused this?
Anything from the store?
Yeah, can you give me a pack of Smurfs?
Sure.
Thanks!
Wash my windows fine, but I can't afford to tip you anything.
Oh, fine. Hey, can I check your oil under the hood?
No!
I should really check your oil. Consumer Reports.
I don't give a fuck about Consumer Reports. Go get someone else's ass. I cannot afford to tip you.
Oh, fine.
Turn that down. License and registration, please. Step out of the car, sir.
Yes. As you can see, the ID we pulled from the body does us a little good. But the dental records do match. We brought in Mrs. Hinklebaum to confirm that this was the body, but then decided that'd be too painful for her to go through.
What about the time of death?
We haven't been able to establish time of death. Mrs. Hinklebaum last saw him 3 days ago. He called running late from work. She sent him to get some errands, you know, buy milk, that kind of stuff. When he didn't return home that night, she called the police. They filed a report and such. 3 days later, he was still missing.
We should check with his credit card companies and local merchants and see where was the last place he was seen alive.
That's a good idea. What happened to this man?
Let me explain it like this. Mr. Hinklebaum here is 6 feet two. His ID says that he weighed 190 pounds. What we have here is less than a third of that. He appears to have suffered from severe dehydration. His body looks like those found out in the desert.
How is this possible? I've seen dehydration victims before. And I've never seen anything like this.
That's because there's never been anything like this before. The human body is 75% water. When a person suffers from severe dehydration, they lose 8 to 10% body water. What we have here is almost 85% body water loss.
You mean this guy was cooked alive?
The thought did cross my mind, but even in cooking, you would absorb more water in the process, and his hair would be singed, parts of the body would be burned.
Did anything else stand out in your investigation?
On the back here, there are these squares that I found that had a more rapid cell rate deterioration. So it appears that whatever happened started on the back.
Excuse me.
I also found some skin and cloth samples under the fingernails. Cloth seems to be a common cotton fiber. Could be anything. Sent the skin to the lab for analysis, which I'll have the test results in the morning.
The North Precinct. All right, we'll be there in a half hour. They found the car. Some kids got it.
He made it sound like the body had been dehydrated at a rate faster than had been seen before. It would have taken over 40 years for the body to dry out that much naturally.
And in only 3 days.
Can I check your oil, sir?
No thanks, we're in a bit of a hurry.
Oh yes, I understand. I'll get you on your way in a jiffy.
What kind of sick fuck could have done this?
By cause of death, I'd say he's some kind of mastermind, but he's definitely not a pro because he left the wallet with the victim's body.
That'll be $12.50, sir.
Okay, just a minute.
Oh, okay.
Here you go. Keep the change.
Oh, thank you kindly, sir.
Don't mention it.
Have a good night.
You too. Let's go see some boys about what they've been up to with these stolen cars.
All right. Get to it.
Do you know why you're here? Do you know why you're not in county yet?
Man, I don't gotta tell you shit without my lawyer present.
Really?
Look here, you little shit. As it is, we've got you for speeding, possession of a stolen vehicle, possession of drug paraphernalia, possession of narcotics with intent to sell. We can put you away for 2 years. What you may not know is that the car we busted you in belongs to a man who was murdered 3 days ago. And you're our prime suspect.
I'm a lover, man. I didn't know the car was stolen. I just bought it, I swear.
We need a name. We need a fucking name.
I can't tell you, ma'am.
My
life could be in danger.
If you think we are going to be nicer than the people on the street, you are sadly mistaken.
You want to be charged with murder? Conspiracy to commit murder? Give us a fucking name!
Pepe.
This guy calls himself Captain Pepe. Captain Pepe Nickelfinger.
He hangs out at the 7-Eleven on Jackson Street.
You're not lying to us, are you, son?
No, sir.
All right, we'll be in touch.
Shit there, buddy.
Hey! We hear you've been selling stuff that doesn't belong. We read through your priors. You're already in possession of low-grade acid, crystal meth, marijuana, and crack cocaine. Word on the street is you got a new ride. Oh, and it ain't so funny, because we found the owner in the park this week. And when we found him, he looked like this. Where were you on the 14th? This is bullshit! This guy is brain dead!
Hey!
We're not gonna get anything out of him until he detoxes! This is bullshit!
Calm down. Hey, I've got an idea. Calm down.
What? What is your idea? So what's your idea?
Just a second. You like that, don't you?
Ooh, yeah, baby. Yeah. Oh, yeah, lick me sticky. Ooh, yeah. I was just chilling, you know, getting my groove on, and I ran into this old friend. So we get our groove on, and my buddy said he wants to introduce me to someone he knows. So we go to this local bar. I sit down at the bar and my buddy introduces me to his friend.
I got so drunk I couldn't find my way into the future. I wonder if you
says he needs to leave town. He can't afford his car no more. Normally, I don't deal with
cars, man, but he seemed like he needed help. I had to help him out.
What was his name?
I don't remember his name.
Well, what did he look like?
Well, I don't know. He was a skinny white boy. He had blonde hair. It was a crazy blonde, bright blonde hair. And he was skinny, emaciated, you know? And crackhead.
Alright, well, it's been fun. See you at the truck.
Remember meeting Mr. Hinkelbaum. You don't remember stealing his car, dropping his body in the park, then ditching the car with Pepe.
Oh yeah, man, that Pepe part sounds familiar.
You met him in a bar. He told him he had to sell the Chevy Blazer to get a ticket out of town. Now why would you have to get out of town?
I don't know, Matt.
You had to leave town because you dehydrated Mr. Hinkelbaum and left his body in the park.
Wait, yeah. No, I didn't do any of that. I didn't do any of that type of shit, man.
You did it.
No, I didn't.
I think you did it.
No, I didn't do it.
You did it, and we can prove it.
No, I did.
You're guilty.
I'm innocent.
You're guilty.
No, I'm innocent.
You're guilty.
I'm innocent.
You're innocent.
Guilty.
You're innocent.
I'm guilty. When I say I'm guilty, I kidnapped Mr. Hinkelbaum. Yeah, I dehydrated him to death, the wet dry shop vac. And I stole his car and I dumped his ass in the park. I had Pepe sell the car so I could get an airline ticket out of here. Are you fucking people happy?
Well, the shop vac would explain the marks on the victim's backs, and it would also explain the dehydration.
Well, it works for me.
Simpsons?
I don't see why not.
customers like that.
But boss, they don't respect me. They don't respect the working man. They don't even want their oil checked. They don't have their own sense for that. I just find them to be a bunch of self-serving, self-service bastards. They just makes me sick, you know?
Well, Chuck, this is your final warning. I'm going to have to tell you. I know a lot of these people are assholes, but you can't do this. You got to keep it to yourself. You got to deal with it.
I don't get treated like this in Oregon. I get respect, a decent wage, you know, that's how I feel.
Yeah, well, maybe you should go back there then. Yeah, well, for now, you can go do the garbage. Be nice.
Yeah, be nice. Be nice. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Be nice. Be nice. Be nice. No respect, no money. No respect, no money, no respect, I tell you.
Kiss someone else's ass. I don't give a shit. I cannot tip you.
Please let me wash your window.
I said no.
Please let me wash your window.
Forget it. I'm in love.
Says you can't go anywhere for $5.
Yes.